The Winnipeg Jets are proud to select from the U.S. Development Program, Jacob Trouba.
Jacob Trouba to the Rangers for Neil Pionk and a first-round pick in the 2019 draft.
Ladies and gentlemen, the New York Rangers have acquired Jacob Trouba from the Winnipeg Jets in exchange for the 20th overall pick in the 2019 NHL draft and defenseman Neil Pionk. The Rangers essentially gave up Kevin Hayes and Neil Pionk for Brendan Lemieux and Jacob Trouba. You're probably saying Jacob Trouba is not a New York Ranger. Well, as of right now, he is still an RFA. So the Rangers do need to sign him. And my guess is that they will eventually sign him. From Rochester, Michigan, he played for the United States National Development Team program. And if you watched the 2019 draft, you heard that a lot the first round. He played 53 games total for the team from 2010 to 2012, tallied 25 points with 7 goals and 18 assists. In 2012, during his National Development Team program days, he was drafted 9th overall by the Winnipeg Jets. He then played for the University of Michigan. In his one season there, which was 2012-2013, he put up 29 points along with 12 goals and 17 assists, all in just 37 games. He signed an entry-level deal in 2013, $894,000 a season for the next 3 years. In his rookie season, he was a +4 and put up 29 points in 65 games. He even cracked double-digit goals in his first NHL season. A sophomore slump in 14-15, where he was still a plus player, but he only had 22 points. In his last year of the entry-level deal, the 14-15 season, he was a +10 player. Played 81 games and had 21 points. He did so good in those 3 years that he was able to get a 2-year, $6 million contract from the Winnipeg Jets. In his first year with that brand new contract that's not an entry-level deal, he was a +4 and put up 33 points, a career-high 25 assists as well. The year after that, in 16-17, a +9 player with 24 points. So you're kind of getting into, it looks like he's a good, reliable defenseman. And that also could come to what kind of team that Winnipeg was when they got him in the draft. So at the end of the 17-18 season, he signed a 1-year, $5.5 million contract to stay in Winnipeg. He can never get a long-term deal done, and that is for personal reasons that we are all speculating and to believe in. A lot of rumors are going around that his wife or fiance is looking to become a doctor somewhat. So basically what they want is to just be, you know, reliable, and they want to make sure that she gets what she deserves in the medical side and wherever she wants to learn from. So, I mean, it's honestly, hockey is a personal sport. You have to always think about where you want to go and how long you want to stay for and take your family into consideration. So that's why the Trouba contract speculation, all those years in Winnipeg, that's why it aroused and that's why it happened. So Trouba with the 1-year deal, the next season, which was this past season, he puts up 50 points. And guess what? Still a plus player. 8 goals, 42 assists for Jacob Trouba. This year was probably the best performance-wise that Trouba has ever played in his career. In my personal opinion, he will be probably playing top 2 minutes on defense. The Rangers cannot be getting a player at a better time of his career. At 25 years old, he's going into his prime. He will probably be playing next to his longtime friend, Brady Shea. And if that doesn't motivate you in some way, for both ways, if it motivates Shea, great. It'll definitely motivate Trouba. And honestly, that might be one of the best top twos that we see in a Ranger uniform since Girardi and McDonough. Jacob Trouba is a hard-nosed defenseman. He's definitely not afraid to take the body, as you've seen in highlights. And also, he has a pretty good offensive touch to his game. We are all very excited for Jacob Trouba to come into Rangerstown. Hope he gets a deal done soon and he'll start practicing and training with some of his fellow Ranger teammates during this offseason. A couple more videos in the future about the Rangers. A couple more videos next week coming out are going to be who in the rebuild should stay with the New York Rangers. Also, I'm predicting line combinations after free agency. So I'm going to be making a video before free agency starts of the New York Rangers roster right now and who is going to be where, you know, where's Zibanejad going, where's Kako going. And then after free agency, if the Rangers decide to pick anybody up, I will slot them in their respective lines and then we'll see and we'll go from there. I'll see you guys later. Hey, thanks for watching the video. If you enjoyed, remember to click the like button. If you want to watch another video, click right there. If you want to watch a play this and start from the beginning, click right there. Remember to subscribe if you want more, and I'll see you guys later.